Hi, welcome to this video where we are going to talk about a neutral conductor and what happens when a neutral conductor actually breaks in a circuit. So in this example, we are using a 120 208 volt three phase source, which we know we would have line one connected up to A phase, line two connected up to B phase, and this circuit as well, we would see a neutral conductor. Now, a neutral conductor, let me get that in, serves two purposes. So a neutral conductor is there to maintain the phase voltages. So in this case, it's there to maintain 120 volts on phase B and 120 volts on phase A. It is also there to carry the unbalanced load, meaning if the two phases have a different load on them, the unbalanced load will go back on a neutral. Now, that's a similar concept to an Edison three wire, which we discuss in another video. Now, so those are the two purposes: maintain phase voltages, carry unbalanced load. Now, what happens is this. Of course, when I look at this circuit, on phase A, I have 8 amps, power factor of 1. On phase B, I have 10 amps, power factor 0.8 lag. Now, power factor aside, I think we can agree that phase B is the higher current and phase A is the lower current, right? Meaning phase A is the less load and phase B has more load. Okay, but what does that mean? Well, in order to have less load or less current, I must have a higher impedance. And in order to have more load, I must have a lower impedance. So our less load, less loaded circuit or lower load has higher impedance. Our more loaded or higher load phase has less impedance or less opposition. Now that's really important. So my question here is this: what happens when the neutral breaks, when I get a break on that neutral conductor? Well, effectively what happens is this: because we no longer have that path for unbalanced load to travel back, we essentially develop a series circuit, starting with line one, going through that resistive load with the power factor of 1, and going through that inductive load back to line 2. Now that series circuit would have a supply of 208 volts across it. Now we're not going to get too much into that series RL math. I do have some videos which you can check out below if you want to get more into that. But essentially, this is what we've created, a series circuit with two. Now keep in mind, the impedance will not change. We agree? Impedance, the resistance and the inductive reactance and the resistance of the coil will not change. Therefore, this still has the high impedance. This still has the low impedance. However, now what changes is the current. It's no longer low current, high current. Now the current is constant, because the current will be the same flowing through both of those loads. What we care about is this: what changes when my neutral breaks is the voltages. We are no longer maintaining phase voltages. In fact, we are going to have a volt drop here, V equals I times Z. And we are going to have a volt drop here, equals I times Z. Because I have a high impedance here, I would have a higher voltage drop across my higher impedance load. Because I have a lower impedance here, I will have a lower voltage drop across that load. So essentially, we are a little bit worried about that, because this load is going to see likely rated or likely higher than rated voltage. The load is rated for 120. We'll likely see it exceed that. This load also rated for 120. We're likely going to see it below that. that can be a problem in electrical circuits. And that's what the neutral helps with. So again, our least loaded circuit, or the circuit with the highest impedance, sees a higher volt drop. Our highest loaded circuit, or our lowest impedance, sees a lower voltage drop. And of course, those would vectorally add up to equal that 208 volt source. So I do hope that clears up some questions about what happens when we do see a neutral conductor break. Of course, in this example, talking about a three-phase source, we didn't discuss anything on phase C, but the same rules would apply. You would have, you know, phase A and phase C in series with 208. You would have phase B and phase C in series between line 2 and line 3. So you can kind of go between there. But those general rules still apply. Higher impedance load, higher voltage drop. Lower impedance load, lower voltage drop. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this helps. If you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up and check out the description below for some of my other videos that could be helpful. Have a great day.